Hey guys, Ralph here, and welcome to True Power Weight Loss Center, one-stop shopping for all your health and fitness needs. This is day four of the True Power Juice Cleanse, and then we're going to touch base with that for a minute, but we're also going to talk about what is going on in the health world, and that is the fallout from the coronavirus. Okay? Now, first of all, day four. What's going on? Could be a lot of things. You could be home free. You could be home free by day four, depending on where you started from and what sort of diet you were starting from and what sort of level of health and fitness you were at when you started. Okay, let's just say you're on the standard American diet. The day four could still be a toughie. Okay, now this is day 11 for me. So I'm on cruise control. It's so simple. There's no hunger whatsoever, no cravings, no fallout from the detox, nothing. Nothing. So anyway, I've been a vegan for 20 years, okay? So there's less toxins in me to come out than it would be somebody, as I said, we're discussing if you're on the standard American diet. Now, you will have, there is such thing as food addictions. We've talked about that in prior videos. There's no doubt about it. You are addicted to food. We all are. That doesn't mean you're weak. That doesn't mean anything. You need food to stay alive. So of course you're going to be addicted to it. Go without oxygen for a few minutes and see if you're addicted to that. I mean, it's the same thing. It's the same thing. And if you have been on the standard American diet, you were addicted to some very, very toxic things. Okay, so let's just go with that. As I said, standard American diet, you are going to feel cravings in your stomach. That is going to be your first withdrawal. When you are hungry, really truly hungry, you do not get any response from your stomach. You get a watering of the throat. You ever had that before? Of course you have. You probably had it and you didn't even know you're having it. But that is true hunger. This morbid sensation that you have in your stomach, that you're craving that you have in your stomach, that is a food addiction, and you should deal with it in a certain way. Now, just for the heck of it, when this comes up, drink a lot of juice. Drink a lot of juice. And you are going to see that even though your stomach is full, okay, sometimes it might be so full, soaked with blue juice that you're actually bloated, okay, but you're still craving food. You see what I mean? It has nothing to do with that morbid feeling in your stomach, okay? That is a food addiction, and that you just have to get past. You just have to get past. You can meditate. Meditate is wonderful, and I'll do a video on that tomorrow, day five meditation. If you are so inclined, I do have a book in my website, all on meditation, that I think you'll find very, very helpful. And I love the book. It's one of my best sellers. And again, I think it's there for $20. I'm not sure. If you want it, send me an email, and I will attach it to a video. Send me $10. Okay, we'll call it a deal. Anyway, meditate. That is a wonderful way to get through some of these. Because, listen, an addiction of any sort at the end of the day, even though there are physical withdrawal symptoms, is in your head. And there is no better way of controlling your mind than meditation. Okay? And I'm going to leave that for another video. But you are also going to have physical reactions to these toxins that are leaving your body. Remember, you're cleansing. Juice cleanse. You're cleansing. And even though much of it is going to end up in the toilet, it comes out in different ways. Guys, it really does. Now, if it's the type that's going to end up in the toilet, you may feel cramps. You may feel extreme gas and then have to run to the toilet. Not unusual. Let it go and enjoy it. That means it's working. Okay? You may have runny eyes. You may have a runny nose. You may be sneezing. You may be coughing. You may have phlegm in your lungs. Almost like you have flu symptoms. That made me think of the coronavirus. Okay? I'm sure it's not. You can tell. You can tell if you have the flu or not. This is, it will usually come and go in waves and all this sort of stuff. That is just toxins getting out of your body, guys. And that's a good thing. Let them go and wish them well. All right. So hang in there with this. Help is on the way. I'm telling you guys, if you're at day four, the hard part's done. The hard part's done. Okay. Now, coronavirus, very, very simple. We don't know a lot about it. At the end of the day, it's a strain of the flu. It is. It depends on how you look at it, guys. We have thousands of cases of the flu every year and thousands of deaths. Okay? And we have, what, 60-some-odd cases of the coronavirus and less than 10 deaths. I'm not saying I'm not making light of the deaths. I'm not making light of the 60 cases, whatever the case may be. But, guys, just try to keep it in perspective. It is not a pandemic at this point. It's nothing to freak out about, okay? You just have to make sure that you are healthy. Now, Louis Pasteur once had an amazing quote that puts everything about disease in perspective, okay? Here's the quote. It's not the microbe, it's the terrain. Think about that. It's not the microbe, it's the terrain. Now, guys, first of all, we have an immune system that in a perfect world is going to fight off every single thing that you come in contact with, and you will not get sick. It will fight it off, okay? It's a very, very strong system in our body, and it should, if it's working well, and I'll get back to that in a second. That's a big point. Take care of it. Take care of anything you come across. Now, also, certainly what I'm about to say depends on where you live, but we live in a very, very toxic environment. Guys, and you are encountering toxins in the things we breathe, the things we eat, the things we drink, you know, our frame of mind, depending on how stressful our job is, can promote toxins. I mean, this is happening all the time. And if your immune system is not strong enough, you'd be sick every single day of the year. And I'm thinking even in the worst case of people that are watching this, you're not. Okay? So your immune system to a certain degree is working. But go back to what Louis said. Okay? It's not the microbe, it's the terrain. Your job is to keep yourself as healthy as you possibly can. And if you are at peak physical health, that's amazing immune system by this contraption called the body is going to be able to fight off any coronavirus, any flu virus that may come in contact. I mean, that's just the way it works. Now, there is no better way, guys. And I'm not trying to sell books in off the coronavirus. I'm not. But at this point, if you are on the standard American diet, there is no better way to ensure your health and make yourself healthy and get this immune system up to fighting capacity than doing a juice cleanse, doing exactly what you're doing. It can be one of the best things for the coronavirus. One of the best things. Okay? Again, by day four, the worst is behind you. And you are going to start to feel great going forward. You're not going to have any more cravings after a while. They're going to be completely gone. You're going to love your juice. You're going to love, you're going to have a positive attitude that you're not going to believe. You're going to have mental clarity that you have never had in your life. Your mind is going to be craving good books and good TV and good movies. You're going to be amazed at the books you start reading and are fascinated with. It clears you out and you are not, you. I'm telling you, if you have never done this and you're on the standard American diet, you are just scratching the surface of how you should be living. And your mental clarity is going to astound you. You're just going to astound yourself. Gee, I'm a smart guy. I didn't know that. Really, guys, this is for me. Now, I've dedicated my life to health, okay? And I, for the most part, have been extremely very lucky and also hardworking and very healthy my whole life. And I have taken a quantum leap. So if you're coming from a sick point of view and a standard American diet, you're gonna take a leap that you are not going to believe. Not going to believe, and you're gonna be able to achieve things that you never thought possible. All right? Stick with it. You're almost there. I'm telling you, day four, the worst is behind you. Okay? Anyway, eat and drink your fruits and vegetables and live your life with true power. If you have a comment or criticism, leave it down below and I'll try to get back to you. Or email me at the email at the end of this video. Okay? Love you all. Have a great day. We'll talk again tomorrow. She says we got a hug.